Hey, welcome back to Alex's Pajamas. We're gonna upgrade Yoshi Gonzi Jr. Because why not? So, Yoshi's actually, he might be my favorite companion ally, as they call it. I mean, Goombella's possibly my favorite because she does the most damage and she's just like super awesome. She got a great personality. I like Yoshi. Oh, excuse me. Jesus. I've been burping a lot into microphones recently. I feel really bad about it. I really shouldn't do it. I like Yoshi a lot anyway. That's what I was saying. So, I'm going to be using him a lot, that's for sure, because his let you walk faster ability is goddamn invaluable. Is that a word? Oh, I fell. So there's a person on the roof that I was trying to get to, like on the far left roof up here, that you can talk to, and I think it might be he. They have very interesting things to say. We're going to take the time to talk to them at some point. I forgot something over here. So I just got a shine sprite. I just wanted to... I'm going to try and get all the shine sprites in this game. Obviously not all the... not all the star shards, which I already said. But the shine sprites are super important. Because you can upgrade your character. So you can upgrade all your allies twice. I don't know if I've just outright said that. So you need an item to upgrade your allies a second time. So for now, so they don't become too overpowered, obviously. So for now, we can upgrade them once, all of them once. And again, I have enough to upgrade Flurry, but I'm not going to use her ever, so I'm not going to upgrade her. Also, fucking this hot speed we got going on right now. Again, it's the game's running at 60 FPS. It looks really good and really smooth, but on YouTube, it's not going to look quite as good. So... show this greedy cheap my fucking ticket. I only call him greedy because his name is cheap. Like, what the fuck do you want me to say? He's probably pretty stingy. And we're going to go back to the Glitz Pit. Again, I love this fucking music. It reminds me of the, reminds me of one Zelda music. I don't remember what it is. I want to say it's like the Happy Mask Shop. But it's not. And it's different than that music, but it just reminds me of it. But yeah, I just love the like the wonderment of like flying in the air and that music's playing. It's just really cool. It's got a really nice ring to it. So we're back. So we just upgraded Gonzi. That's all we had to do. I wanted to do that. Got a couple of shine sprites because, you know, it's good to have them. And it's just a good idea to have Gonzi Jr. upgraded because he's super handy. Again, he might be my favorite companion. There's the Chapter 5 companion's really good. The Chapter 4 one's really good, but I never use her enough. And the last companion's pretty good. You only get companions up through Chapter 6, unfortunately. But that's fine. They're all, you know, unique and interesting, so. So we have everything we need, so we're going to go fight. So we have to fight the handovers again. I think I have to not use my hammer or something. We'll figure it out. I'm sure we'll be fine. Okay. It's fine. Let's see. What do you want me to do, Grubba? Hand it over. You can take me and Gonzalez? Ha! I have to pay. So I missed my chance to pay attention before. I have to pay attention right at the beginning of this battle. What's it say? Don't use special moves. Okay. I can handle that. So we're going to show you Gulp, which is one of the best moves in the game. Which is that. So you like... that's what we have to use on the Adonis twins. Which is super clutch. It's the only way to beat them, actually. We need to... ground pounds this guy. So, the thing about Yoshi... Oh, I fucked it up. Stylish commands right before he goes. The thing about Yoshi is, his attack is, so I just did 5 damage with his ground pound. So it's really strong, but it only, each hit does 1 damage. I keep fucking up his stylish. There we go. I got one of them. So like right before he spins, you can hit A and he'll do like extra spins. It's pretty cool. Yoshi's just super good. Like his fourth ability that he gets when you upgrade him a second time is so good. It's like, it's incredibly useful, especially against a ton of enemies. So we had to fight that guy since we lost a match against a better person. That's the only match I intend on losing. That's for sure. I've only ever lost one other match before, so. Outside of that, the one that you have to lose. Now listen, son, this battle, I want you to wrap it up in 5 turns or less. I can absolutely do that. So you can't leave, also. There's no exclamation mark for the door. But yeah, the thing about Yoshi's attacks is it does like 5 really quick attacks, and when you upgrade him again, it does 6. So that's like, it's a lot. But they all do 1 damage each, so if the person has any defense at all, doesn't hurt them, unfortunately. But if it's like a Koopa, since it's a jump attack on them, the first will knock them down and all the other ones will do damage. Gonzalez, let me out. We're gonna take these punks this time. Stinkwatch challenging us again. He never learns. Looks like he brought some shrimpy partner, as if that's gonna help him. Oh, this motherfucker's talking shit. Talk shit, get shot. Ouch! You spiked me right in the. That really hurt. Our arm bodies are in pointy nastiness are being used against us. No fair. Aw, oh, dang, bro. Has he discovered our weak points? I'm just gonna appeal. Hey, everybody. You know, you wonder. These guys are ranked, they're ranked 10 in the Glitz Pits. It's like, you know, they're in the major leagues, but they're not that high. Why did I do this? Terrible idea. Mistakes were made. I'll try the piercing blow. It's not going to work, but. Which is bullshit. They only made it not work against these guys. Because they can't. They have to be beaten by Yoshi. He only get 10 experience for it. Goddamn criminal. It sucks because something. Do we have to go back to the minor league now, bro? I think I'm gonna be sick. Congratulations, Great Gonzalez! With this win, you made it to the major league. Now that, folks, is what I call a wild and woozy fight. A diggity-dang doozy. Keep it up, kid. Get going, place. I can tell. Howdy. Hooey. Come on now, folks. Give it up. We have a new major leaguer. Let's hear it for him. For him. Let's hear it for him would probably be how you would say that. You know what? I have to improvise all this. I can't just know what they're going to say. Here's your fight money, Mr. Gonzalez. Oh, 7 whole coins. Mr. Gonzalez, Mr. Grubber wishes to see you in his office. Follow me. The thing is, like, the Adonis twins are, they're unbeatable or whatever, but, like, 10 people have beaten them. 11 people have, or 10, yeah, I guess. Mr. Grubber, I've brought Mr. Gonzalez as you request. He was looking at something at his desk, if you missed it. Miss Jolene, you mind your manners now. We knock around here, missy. I apologize, Mr. Grubba. Don't you worry your pretty little head about it. None. None. Now, what I want again? Something about Gonzalez. Oh, yeah. This young little boy. What? like his hair. Gonzalez, you old so-and-so. Let me congratulate you, son. Major League already, huh? I had a feeling you were going places, and dang, I love it when I'm right. You just keep on putting Turkishes in them seats. I'm counting on you, son. I got a special little something for you. Go on, take it. You got 30 coins. That's a nice bonus. Yeah, something else has been on my mind. Your costume ain't cool. No big deal, son, but hey, someday if you become champ, I'll get you a new one. Something hot pink, maybe, with some frills or something. You'll look a sight, son. I don't know why he says that. I have no idea. It's still a mystery to me today if he's, like, being genuine or sarcastic. I can't tell. It's text. Like, what am I supposed to think? Anyway, that's something for another day, Pa. Take a powder, okay? Take a powder? Like a powder break? You want me to doll myself up? Mr. Gonzalez, please follow me if you would. Oh, my neck. Oh, cracked my neck. Don't know if the microphone picked that up, but it happened. For sure happened. Yo, check it out. This guy's standing aside for this major leaguer over here. It's very quiet in here. This is the major league locker room. You will use this room from this moment on. The match system is the same as the minor league, but the bouts are harder. Try not to get completely destroyed out there, okay, Mr. Gonzalez? Well, if you'll excuse me, I must be going now. Crickets. I hear crickets, I think. What's the deal? Would it kill these guys to show a little friendliness? Sheesh. Oh, boy. Steadily guy coming through. Listen up, losers. I've been hearing about some rising star tearing up the league. It's you, isn't it? Yeah, you fit the bill. Skinny, a mustache named Gonzalez. Man, I came all the way over here for you? What a waste of time. Huh? Uh-huh. What's your deal, Gonzalez? Huh? Oh, the champ's belt. What in the... Hey, you! Get too close to the hawk and you might get rocked! I'm not sure, but it definitely looks weird. I think you're right, Gonzalez. Fake! Hey, you think you can smack talk the rock hawk? I don't think so. You got some nut guts calling my belt a fake, you shrimpy no-belt-having wimps. Didn't your mama teach you any manners? Whoa, sorry, yellow dude. I didn't mean to rip on your big, bad belt. Stop making fun of me, punk! You're alive only because we ain't in the ring right now. If I see you under those lights, I'll tear you apart. Remember the Rock! I love Rock Hawk so much. He's such a great character. Wow, I really pushed that dude's buttons, huh? Well, forget him. We got a problem. Your map pointed at Glitzville, right? That dude's belt has a fake crystal on it. Then where the heck is the real one at? Was that your mailbox SP going off? Who'd you get an email from? Love this music.
If you want the crystal star, heed my instructions.
From X. You have to read these serial killer messages with that voice. Who the heck is this X dude? He talks like he's the man to see about the crystal star. Why would he want to help us out, though? This whole deal seems kind of whack.
If you want... Would you fuck me? I'd fuck me.
That's the Silence of the Lambs. Go watch that movie. It's a classic, I'll tell you what. Also, you never go in the bathroom, fun fact. Occupied! Some dude in there. You're pretty tough, baby. But you're really gonna have to power up to win here. Hey, where'd you get the hammer? You're biting my style. I'm the hammer guy. I'll be the champ someday, you bet. Uh-huh, that's right. Just like the big legendary champion, Prince Mush.
Destroy the foe before you. That is the only concern of a true warrior.
So we're going to be fighting pretty much all new enemies from here out, and they give a lot of experience, so I'm not too worried about getting two levels for the next little bit. Alrighty then, let me just see. Your next opponent will be Rank 9 in the Glitz Pit, the Tiny Spiners. Now listen, son, this battle, I want you to stand pat, okay? Do not attack at all. Crowd loves you, partner, so give them what they want. Drive them bonkers. Now get in there and share that spotlight. So in this case, Mario can't attack at all. Which is fine for this specific fight. Later on, it's a little bit fucking hairier. And I don't mean, like, the jet. The hairier jet. Also, it's Friday, so it's an extra long episode today. You know, it might not necessarily be Friday for you, but this came out on a Friday, so just bear with me, okay? Yeah, yeah. Whee! It's gonna be fun poking at... Poking fun at you? Is that what you said? It's gonna be fun poking fun at you? Is it poking you? Poking holes in you, maybe. That's cryptic. Do, 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 do. So we wanna just... Let the partner do all the talking over here with the whoops and the wind and it. It's a red spike tops. Most well protected the buzzy beetle species. Not true. There's one that's flying and has a spike on it. Max HP is 5, attack is 3, and defense is whopping 5. Yep, this guy is hard. Really, it has really high defense and fire that and explosions don't hurt it at all. We can just find a way to flip it over. Its undersized defense is 0. And its spike. What a pain. There's got to be a way to flip it over. We're just going to swap partners now. And that'll be that. And obviously, now enemies with high defense are no longer an issue because we've got Gulp. And even if you don't have an enemy to throw the enemy at, Gulp still does the damage. So... worth noting. So yeah, having a Yoshi is kind of a game changer. There's no ally quite like him in the first Paper Mario. You received 11 coins. Mario's ranking rose to 9. Now if you'll excuse me, I must be going. Snap, 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 snap. We'll just go on to the next match. Well, boy, I'm fixing for final. This opponent will be ranked 8 in the Glitz Pit. The Poker Faces. Ma, 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 ma. Now, listen, this battle, I want you to keep that part of yours from attacking. You hear me? Keep that little firebrand in check. Got it? Only you attack. Now, get in there and show them who's boss. So, this is the opposite of last time. Again, the challenges just become a little bit trickier here. Nothing like crazy, but. You know, they're tricky. They're tricky, you know what I'm saying? I want, like, there to be another, like, Paper Mario RPG. You know, that isn't Sticker Star, obviously. Just because this is so good. Like, I want them to do, like, a new Glitz Pit or whatever. It's just so good. Again, I need to play Sticker Star, but, like, that's just, like... To my knowledge, there's nothing, like, interesting about it. Like... There isn't, like, cool dynamic levels. Oh, we've seen these guys before, so we're just gonna go for it. Use our hot earth tremor move and fucking clock these guys out. Ironically enough, we're not using clock out. Because clock out sucks, guys. I said it. It was very handy for that one specific scenario we used it in, but whatever. Sweet Treat's really handy. I haven't been taking a ton of damage this playthrough. There was one missed opportunity with it earlier, and I later said, oh, that was a missed opportunity to use Sweet Treat. Gosh, dang it. Those guys still get a ton of experience. Wow. I think they load up more experience for the Glitz Pit, though, for these Glitz Pit fights, though. Because I feel like they gave the same experience when we fought them way back when outside Petalburg. Excuse me, how are we going? Blah, blah, blah. I think we're going to get our first message. It's not an email, right? Don't just stand there. Check it.
Go to the watering hole outside the Glitz Pit.
It's from that X guy again. Great. The watering hole? Huh. If you say so, X. Who is this mysterious guy?
Go to the watering hole. Because I said so.
I just like doing that voice. I'm not ever going to get another chance to do it on like a Let's Play or whatever. So whatever game I play next is probably going to have voice acting. Oh no, I said I would play Super Paper Mario. We don't have to do that like right next. Also, notice that you're up here. So hey, now we can talk to people. They'll say different stuff. Whoa, whoa, wait a minute. You're Gonzalez, ain't you? Let me take a shot. Yo, yo, great Gonzalez. Two questions. How are you feeling today? And if you were a soda pop, what flavor would you be? I love that, like, kind of play on the fucking stupid interview questions. Oh, well, Mr. Mustache, you made it to the major league, have you? I keep a whisker tweak, love. Something stinks here, and it's not a ripe cheese. Call it a thief's intuition. Better safe than sorry, my sweet. You know what? I appreciate it. Well, hello there, you haughty, heroic he-man of a man. He-man of a man. You're lovely, dear. The gossips have it that you've made some headway in the major league. But I doubt you can beat Rock Hawk, you poor thing. You're simply too stringy. The only man for me is the one wearing that shiny belt. Toodaloo! But it's cool. You have your own poster up now. Great Gonzalez. Which I think is cool. And soon that's going to change. As you get bigger and bigger, you're going to have many more posters. No one's going to care about Rock Hawk anymore, I'll tell you that much. So this is the watering hole. Fresh juice. Oh, you're Mr. Gonzalez. Yeah, that's the mustache I've been waiting for. Actually, you're pretty late. Somebody left a package and a note by the door a bit ago. The letter said, look for a thick-stache man named Gonzalez and give him this. The letter was talking about is this. You got a super hammer. Yay. Pink background. And it's our good friend, Toadette. She's so cute. Hey, it's me again, Toadette. So nice to see you again, Mario. Aww. Congratulations on getting that super hammer. It's way more powerful. Plus, you can also use it. A wicked cool new technique. Want to learn about it? Sure we do. Let's practice. So, the super hammer has like the super hammer ability, which is when you hold B, spin around, spin. Which is cool. It's totally new to this game. Oh, excellent, Mario. You're so awesome. Want to try it again? Now I got it. Okay, great. You've mastered the super hammer. With the super hammer move, you can break even big blocks like this. So before, you could just break different style blocks. You need a super hammer and battle too. Try it. See you later, Mario. Good luck with your new quest. So far as I could tell, that hammer is the new model, the Hammer Whack 2005. This came out in 2004. This game did, for reference. Real nice hammer all around. Solid craftsmanship, good grip, high bonkability. The commercials for this thing say the hammer chooses its user. You aren't cheap by it, so whoever gave this to you must be a big fan, but why leave this in a juice shop? Doesn't that strike you as a bit odd? I mean, it's not like it's that hard to hand a gift to a pro fighter. Interesting. Mario, another email.
Smash the blockade in the minor league locker room.
Blockade in the minor league locker room, huh? What's behind it, you think?
Fucking me, that's what, would you?
I read a tweet that somebody just sent me and I lost my train of thought. Yeah, I like the super hammer. In the first Paper Mario, when you got a new hammer, you just got a new hammer, it just broke, like, gray blocks. Instead of,
I yawn real quick.
Instead of, like, you didn't get an ability with it. Ah, Gonzalez, isn't it? I got the word that you wanted to move back down to the minor league again. Can't say I understand why, anyway. Go on in. Hey, it's Mr. Stinkwad. What are you doing here? That's the older of the Iron Adonis twins. You can tell he's older by his red shoes. I don't think they took their loss to you too well, Mario. I'd be careful around them. That's the younger of the Iron Adonis twins. He and his brother totally hate you. It's a rule that older brothers wear red shoes and younger brothers wear green. Is it a rule? That's fucking really funny. I've never read that dialogue, so I was curious. If you want to fight outside the ring, I'll give you a fight, you big jerk. Mr. Gonzalez, you're back in the minor league? What's the matter, Bomb? Did he leave something in here? Bomb?
Ah, his mustache here again. Here to laugh at Clefdor. Grach.
Yoshe? God damn it. Again with the jumping. I'm just bad at this. Yeah, so you get three different hammers in this game and three hammers in the previous Paper Mario, but you get like new ability with the second hammer. It's the same for the third one, unfortunately. Whoa, Gonzalez. That's some kind of scientific paper on the crystal stars. Who'd be investigating those things besides us? They even took pictures. Who'd leave something like this lying around? It just reeks of funny business. This is old back room, like a bookshelf and a broken computer. It's very, very reeky. You again. Mr. Gonzalez, what are you doing in here? Oh, she seems pissed. This is a minor league locker room. Major league athletes are forbidden. Even if they weren't, it's hardly appropriate to bash down our walls, hmm? Well, I mean, let me explain.
I told him to do it.
I'll just be confiscating this, thank you very much. Oh, great, thanks. Maybe you should have fucking put it away, Mario. Slip it into your trousers.
God damn it.
Dang, what's with her? You busted our humps getting that information. Some people just gotta...
rain on parades.
Why am I so yawny? I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry if I'm making you yawn. Well, at least we know the crystal star is here. True. Small comfort, but, you know. What you gonna do? I don't think he's gonna let me back in. We're gonna save. Problem with this chapter is, like, you don't save as often as you should. So if you actually do die, one time I think I died on the boss by accident. I just wasn't paying enough attention. And, ended poorly. I had to start, like, half the chapter over again. Boy, how it gone sounds figured for fight. Alrighty then, let me see the next opponent will be. Rank 7, the Glitz Pit. The Shell Shockers. And listen, son, this battle, I want you to wrap it up in 5 times or less. I got a date with a cute little chickadee in just a few, and I don't want to be late. Now get in there and bring this puppy home quick. Of course. If anything for your fucking date, Grubba. How about you share the love. Be my wingman. Clearly you know what's up. Got a date with a chickadee. Who calls girls chickadees? Single people, that's who. Ugh, these guys. These guys are tough. Don't be deceived. So-called Great Gonzalez. Don't think I'm going to take it easy on you, baby. He said baby, right? I'm not crazy. I wasn't just projecting some weird sexual interest onto him. We're going to tattle this guy so we can't use this fucking Thunder Shroom item. Now, we do have our Super Hammer, but we're not going to worry about it right now. Oh, yeah, that's right. These guys are more dangerous on their backs, but they can't use items. Like that, now he's down, but I still have to tattle these guys. Shady Koopa, Koopa finish, Taxi, Defense 3. Difference between them and the other Koopas, they can attack from their backs. They flip it back, Taxi, over here is 8. Wow, it's pretty tricky. No wonder they're called Shady Koopas, huh? Damn it! Do we want a Super Hammer? Sure. Let's see. What do we want to do? All right, we want to kill this guy first. Always go for the enemy with the item, just because. Like, come on. God damn it! I'm really fucking up. That was the third turn though, so we're doing okay. We'll just do it in 5 turns. I said 5 turns or less, so. Oh, okay, cool. I keep fucking up on the the stylish time as well. Okay, so we are almost to level 9. And we should be able to make it to level 10 by the Raw Clock fight. What do you expect, huh? We rock. Some of the, like... Gonzalez! Oh, these guys. Coming to fight. Oh, Nelly, I don't believe my eyes, folks. The Iron Adonis twins are in a rage. You made us look like suckers the other day. Now we're going to pay for it. Aw, a little tired from your match. Great stinkwad. Too bad. Prepare for pain. I mean, I guess. I love when this just happens. Happens multiple times in this, while you're in the glitz pit. Which is silly and awesome. Ow. Oh, shit. We want to item. So now's a great time for Sweet Treat. To have to have it. I love this music so much. God damn it. So there's like a upgraded version of Sweet Treat that you get later, actually. It's called Sweet Feast. And it's the second best special move that you get. And the first best one is amazing. I forgot about like the surprise matches for a second. So we're going to have to start healing before every... That's the great of Gonzalez, friends of Navis. Kid don't even blink when the Iron Adonis twins barge in and attack. Woo, tough. He's too dang tough. Yeah, this kid's only bounding for bigger things, folks. Till next time, everyone. See ya. Here's your fight money, Mr. Gonzalez. We're going to heal between every match because we have to. There's only one other surprise match. Surprise fight, but... Another email? What now? Keep sticking your nose where it doesn't belong, and you are D-E-A-D-M-E-A-T. Man, that dude sounds peeved. I'm thinking that isn't our ex-buddy. Who do you think would send something like that? Somebody who knows how to fucking type without looking like a serial killer? You're dead meat, meaning I'm gonna eat you and make your face a lamp. Which happens in Silence of the Lamb. No, it's a nipple lamp. The lamp has nipples. Well, boy, I had a Gonzalez fix for Fireheim, but race 6 the glitch pit. The fuzz. Now, listen, son, this battle, I want you to wrap it up in 5 turns or less. Yes, you got a date with a goddamn cute chickadee. I'm glad it went fucking so well that you get to call her chickadee again. Sounds like Chickateague, which is an island that my friend's family has a house on. They don't own the island. It's like a vacation resort spot. It's like a small town on a relatively small island. Very nice place. I've only been there once. Very nice people there. They have a great ice cream shop on Chickateague. Love to go back. It's bottomless vacuums. Meark, meark, we're gonna suck up your souls. Jesus Christ, man. So some of these, and then you get to meet the other types of fuzzies. Some of these guys fucking, some split into two. I think it's the green guys that do that. So we're gonna try and kill these fuckers first. And the others, suck up your FP. Max HP is 5, attack is 3, defense is 0. This is similar to the normal fuzzy. So it replenishes its own HP and sucks out ours. Ew! It's just the grossest thing ever! You don't find that idea gross. Seriously, there's something wrong with you. The main difference between this and the other fuzzy is this one multiplies. You know, I bet this thing would look great sitting next to a gold fuzzy. We're gonna kill this guy. Oh no, I fucked it up! Nice. He's gonna fucking. Oh, okay. Fuck. Now he's got full health again. Oh. Lucky. These guys suck up your FP, which fucking is the worst. It doesn't do damage to you, though. But it's totally pretty fuzzy. Wow, what a totally pretty fuzzy, don't you think? Max HP is 6, attacks 3, and defense is 0. This thing attacks by absorbing, by boinging and sucking out FP. How uncool. We need FP. Once it charges up its own FP, it uses magical attacks. Better beating it before it does. I've never actually seen that. It's a flower fuzzy because it sucks up your... Oh, I just got it. It's a flower fuzzy because it sucks up your FP flower points. Duh. There we go. Did not fuck it up that time. I tried to super guard. And it was like the worst timing. The timing on that's just like the regular ass timing on that's just super fucking tricky. Yeah, don't get any fucking star points for them. Peace! We got enough experience to level up. Yay, I didn't even notice it. It worked out perfect. What do we want to level up? HP, right? So we leveled up badge points. We want HP next. So we just need 100 more star points within the next, like, 6 matches or whatever. See? No biggie. Okay, good. It didn't happen yet. There's something that's going to happen that's I did not expect. And it was amazing when it first happened. And it's still great. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be going. I think we'll have some stuff to do after this match. Maybe. Oh, there's cake. Hey, you, Gonzalez. Jolene brought you a piece of cake from a fan, I guess. Looks totally yummy. If you chow down on that, I bet you can ride the sugar rush. Heck yeah! Yeah, let's eat. You're fully recovered. Yay. Well, boy, howdy, Gonzalez. Fixing for a fight, huh? Well, alrighty then. Let me see here. Next opponent will be rank 5 McLispit, the Crawl Daddy. Listen, son, this battle I want you to avoid using your hammer. Not even once, son. I want to see how you do when you ain't got something to beat a fellow with. That's okay. Very descriptive. Very descriptive text. There we go.
Let's make out. Goomba, let's make out.
Okay, we'll make this the last match. We've been going on. This extra long episode has turned into an extra long episode. Oh, this guy. Merciless Executioner, Great Gonzalez, and Doc Gatekeeper. Yep, fight with the finished Crawl Daddy. We aren't going to lose to scrubs like you.
Foolish mortals, I will drag you through the gate to the netherworld.
Whoa! Creepy! Again, some of the writing in this game is just kind of surprising. That's a dark crawl. Yikes, what a ghastly looking spear thrower. Max HP is 20, attack is 6, and defense is 0. Wow, that's some serious attack power. You don't want to jump on it if its spear is pointing up, because that would hurt. For a run-of-the-mill spear tosser, he sure looks like he's got a point to make. Goombella. Why did I appeal? I tried to swap partner. But, you know. I guess we all make mistakes. So I can't use my hammer, so I'll swap partner. We'll do Gonzi Jr. And he'll do throw eggs and enemies strengthen. Because his attack power drops when you do that. Which is saying, so the piranha plant just ate one of the other audience members. That's what that sound is. For reference. Again, so you shrink enemies and it lowers their attack power. I guess because we have those soft boots, right? And it said soften enemies. This is like 10 episodes ago. And I'm like, what the hell does that mean? So I think that lowers their defense. Oh, ooh. There's some close calls for that one. You guys didn't see my thumb going, but we were running into danger, that's for fucking sure. Oh, God, he's not fucking These guys are trying to throw a tin can at me so you can boot them off. I can't use my hammer. So... I guess just hang out. Defend. We'll... Gulp again? Yeah, we'll gulp again. Yeah, I guess we just have to keep gulping. No, actually, I'll... To save FP, because... Just in case that surprise round is here again, we'll switch to Koops. I fucked it up, but it's fine. Still won. You get 10 experience. Again, some of the later ones, you get like 30 experience for a fight. And it's cool. Maybe I'll fuck up a couple times on purpose, just to, beat one? Cool. Yeah, here it comes. Mario! Fucking Bowser shows up. Whoa, another fight is storming and screaming his fool's head off about something. Gonzalez has lots of foes, folks. Some who don't even know his name. Will he live? Word on the street was that some mustache doofus was in Glitzville, and looky here. Talk about perfect timing. Now all these folks have to watch me myrtleize you. I am going to destroy you, and I have witnesses. Let's power smash. So he has one defense. Tricky bit about Bowser. But he's fun. He's a fun fight. He's tough, but he's fun. We're gonna sweet treat also, because we used all our FP in that last match, because we had to. Which was bullshit. That's what I was worried about. You get a ton of experience for this fight, though. Ooh, three fucking poison shrooms back to back. Oh, we missed two. Three, damn. So there's eight total of each, it looks like. Let's tattle on Bowser. And I wanted that to be... This is a good endpoint for our week. That's Bowser. What's he doing here? My mind just blew a fuse. Max HP is 30, attack is 3, defense is 1. He's uglier than I expected. He's got a poisonous bite, so watch out. It'll make your HP decrease gradually. Also, if he ground pounds on you, you won't be able to use one of your commands. Just focus your attention on beating him down, Mario. Whew. Close one. What is a better idea? I mean, power stomp, power jump, and power smash are the same. So we'll just power and power smash. So again, like, there are scenarios where the hammer makes more sense than the jump. Just because, oh! Well, I expect nothing less from you, Mario. Figures you get some licks in. Sweet. Didn't take... The hammer's a better idea than jumps. He has defense, so... I'll do more damage... Oh, fuck. I'll do more damage with, the hammer than I will with the jump. Let's see. Guess we'll just do this, and I'm gonna switch to Koops. Because Gonzi Jr. is actually not going to do anything. Oh, sweet. That's actually super lucky. So I can switch to Gonzi Jr. now and use his gulp ability. Yeah, let's do that. Bowser's not having any luck with the attacks, I'll tell you that much. And we'll finish it quick. It's awesome, because when you shrink Bowser, he's still fucking gigantic. Because, you know, he's Bowser. That was close. I'll just jump on his head. Classic style. Ah! Oh, he didn't give you a lot of experience. I thought he was going to give me more. 15 star points. Gah. Ooh, that's Hawk Gonzalez. He don't even bat an eye when someone nuts ambushes him. Tough. You're too tough, son. You're only going to get tougher. Stay tuned, folks. Till next time, everybody. See ya.
See ya.
He's just like, pee. Here's your fight money, Mr. Gonzalez. I should get a little bonus, I think, for fighting Bowser, the Koopa King. I like how no one knows who Bowser is, also. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be going. Everybody knows who Bowser is the thing. Wow, that was the King of Koopas, wasn't it? Wow, that guy's insane. Alright, well, next time on Hog's Plays, sorry for an extra long episode. Triple length instead of double length. We're gonna keep going through the glitz pit and see if we can find that crystal star. So, see you guys.